Hey again, guys. Back to Deus Ex. And I didn't go in here yet.
So what did these ones die of, Savage?
Complete neurological breakdown, from the looks of it. Organ collapse, nerve degradation.
Find him. There's been some trouble on the base. My man will take care of it. You're saying?
We may be looking at serious cross-systemic failure issues with the OCM.
If those god-awful implants, Gary, the whole inhumane procedure, after a while it just burns them out.
Has this been happening at the other sites?
We've experienced some die-off, yes, but I've been told Dr. Reed's research may offer a breakthrough. If we could bring her back here...
That's not going to happen.
Then we need to start considering other options. A nanotech-based solution performed on willing volunteers.
And are you volunteering yourself, Doctor?
Tiffany, please. I need to look at the raw data, Commander. If you would.
I turned a blind eye to your little office romance, Savage. But if she becomes a problem, she will be volunteering.
Keitner, I found out what Burke's been concealing. The interrogation wing is some kind of medical testing facility. He's using the prisoners as lab rats.
For what?
Not sure. I'll need Burke's retinal scan data to find out.
I can't download that without setting off a million alarms. However, Burke's eyes are enhanced, Jensen. He uses special retinal prostheses custom-made for him by the Tai Young Medical Corporation.
You want me to remove Burke's eyes?
Not the ones he's currently using. He just received a new set this evening for when the cargo ship docked. With any luck, you'll find it in his office. Keitner out.
To find his eyes. Fun times. I saw a pad here. There it is. Alright. Well, let's go, continue on our merry way. Except we can't, because we have to go back to his office. Which means it's time to backtrack. She's still upset.
You can't keep me caged up here. Like, you changed your mind. You'll let me out now? Please, they'll be back and I'll disappear like all the other women.
Okay. You can't do anything yet. I was curious to see if that was possible, but apparently not. Alright, well, we'll just run back here, I guess. Well, looks like we're really loading back.
Activating security scan.
Thank you, loading screen. I don't really see how this is necessary, but whatever.
Biometric data assembled.
I bet it has been. Alright. Yeah, someone already told me I apparently missed a trank rifle fairly early on, and, that wasn't really important, though, because I'm obviously not going for a non-lethal run, so missing the trank rifle, not a big deal. So, I will not cry myself to sleep. Or maybe I will. Who knows? So his office is downstairs. Wait, what's here? Not know where I want to jump to. Alright, let's go check out what's down in his office. Actually, wait, we haven't gone We didn't go through here? Huh. Hi, robot. Goodbye, robot. Or goodbye me. Or no, I'll just juke him and go this other way. Whatever. What was the point in that room? I actually want to go back there and see. Well, there's another room. Apparently I didn't explore these completely. Well, this one at least has a way down. is the Kleenex room. Alright, we'll actually go down here. Huh. Interesting. Alright, let's go to his office. This really actually is a lot of backtracking, surprisingly. Game didn't have a whole lot of this earlier. Are you serious? You know, up until now, because this game kind of got a lot of shit. Yeah. This game got a lot of shit, and I wasn't really understanding why, because I thought the length was pretty normal. Like, considering I paid $15 for this, and, I didn't pay $15 for this, I paid $5, but the original game I paid $15 for. That was roughly, I think, 30 parts or so, I don't remember. And this one's already turning out to be, like, at least 8, I would say. I'm hoping 10.
Subject recognized. Access granted.
Which kind of confused me as to why people thought it was too short or whatever, but I can kind of see the problem now. Like, there's no... I'm just following these markers and just going up.
I've got something.
Nope. Stab in the leg. And he just turned around on me. Oh, I just let the alarms go off. Oh, whatever. I got a pistol now. Yeah, I know. No, the alarm's gonna go off. Now, go down there. Come on. Go down. There we go. That solves that problem of ours. Wait, we're supposed to be over here. Oh, this isn't level 1 before. I don't really know. Anyways, the alarms are already going off, so I don't really care now. Alright, I'll just do this. Let's go do the hacking minigame that we've seen all too many times.
Access.
Alright, we got it all. Well, not all, but, you know. We got enough. Alright, so here we have an ebook. And some more whiskey. Oh, Kiker, there it is.
I've got the eye, but it's not gonna fool a retinal scanner unless it's attached to an optic nerve.
I know that, Jensen. I do have a plan. Take the eye down to Quinn. He'll know what to do. Keitner out.
Yeah, I'm gonna get the eye implanted into me. That's wonderful. It's a downgrade! Oh, so I'm taking it down to Quinn. Oh, I didn't find all his rocket parts, though. Whoa. Whoops. Kind of flashbang myself.
Too late to hide.
I love them grenades. Hey, what's this I missed? Oh no, those are the TMP guns. I remember those now. Wait, this guy? Oh no, he's dead. Good. I want everything to die. I'm bloodthirsty. No, I don't know. Alright, I guess back down to Quinn. Oh yeah, I took the other way up. Let's just throw that for no reason. Because I'm bored, and I'm waiting for that. Cool pipes. Oh, no, okay, it's here. Let's go down. Well, I'll see how long the rest of this game takes. I'm a little bit curious myself to see, how long it is. Some people are saying how they regretted buying it when it was 15. Once again, I'll make up my own mind, sorry. Oh yeah, right, this is the expo stuff.
So, what's the story? Just got off the horn with the commander. She says you got something for me to take a look at.
Prosthetic eye, one of Burke's. We needed to get past a retinal scan, but it's useless like this.
Without an active neural connection, it might as well be an expensive paperweight. May as well put a gobstopper in front of the scanner for all the good that thing will do you.
Solutions, Quinn. Think you can handle this?
Lad, I may be just a mechanic, but I'm also the only thing keeping this whole bleeding facility from sinking into the abyss. Think I can manage a simple optic frequency bypass? Just let me get me tools. Right. So that's it now. You got the eye. Sorry it took a little longer than I expected. Nearly break the damn thing once or twice. New TYM firmware and such. Now don't go fucking around with it. It's only got a limited lifespan due to the temp power source I rigged. It's only good for one use. Got it?
Why only one use?
Without being hooked up to a proper battery, like your brain, the voltage spike from a single scan will trip the surge protectors, shutting it down to prevent further transmissions. It's a redundant safety mechanism built into the optic nerve to prevent frying your noggin in a dorsal ventral feedback loop. Short of putting the thing in your own head, which I ain't exactly equipped to do, there's no way around it. Besides, I think the commander preferred this way.
Is it supposed to be moving?
Aye. Bloody creepy that is. Try not to pay it any mind now. Thing's stuck in calibration mode. Trick is, I got it thinking it's plugged into a new host. And by rerouting the system diagnostic checks, it'll keep trying to connect without detecting anything to miss, which in turn keeps it alive in a manner of speaking. Fucking brilliant piece of engineering work, if I don't say so myself.
This is pretty impressive work for a mechanic, Quinn.
What's that supposed to mean? There's more to old Quinn than meets the eye. No pun intended. You wouldn't be the first fool to underestimate my know-how.
Well, there's more to this job than just a simple battery swap. I saw you modifying the BIOS. This is state-of-the-art hardware and software. You're not just a mechanic. You're a hacker.
What are you going on about now? Ain't nothing you couldn't pull off with a degree in computer engineering and a little elbow grease. Come off it now. We ain't got time for this.
Well, hopefully this thing works.
It'll work just dandy so long as you don't do something stupid like drop it. And it ain't a bloody webcam. So don't try using it to spy the knickers up someone's skirt. What are you buying?
Alright, let's see what he's got. He's got some combat ammo. I can take some of that. I never did use a revolver from the last game. Real shame. I probably won't be doing that this year, this game either. Alright.
No refunds.
I like that, that's what he tells me. That's the important thing he needs to let me know. Okay, let me go and use this. And also, whoops, sorry, that's the wrong menu. I meant this menu. Let's go do recoil reduction. Because, why not? So, absolutely no recoil anymore. It just seems fun. Combat AUGs. The weapon seems kind of thin. It's probably because of the field of vision I actually have on. It's on 100, so. Very thin looking pistol. Or maybe that's just the universe. Oh, I never used the Typhoon either. Oh, shit, we gotta do that. Oh, there is always the final boss. Oh yeah, that's right. I'm going this way. Take care. Oh great, now we gotta go through all these loading screens again. Yeah, really, this served no purpose other than to artificially increase the length of the video. It's like, oh, well, like, you can't chase them, or you gotta go back, like, two levels. And they spawn a couple enemies there, but it's very clear what they did there. You can't fool me. Because these are seriously loading screens.
Subject recognized. Access granted.
Fubuck says enemies gonna have probably spawned here too. Nope, apparently I owe you guys $5. There's a vent cover. So I'm guessing there's no sniper rifle, because this feels endgame-ish, because I'm following him, and he's probably the final boss, I would guess. Yeah, I'm just gonna eat some painkillers. There we go. I have 200 health all the time. Those traps are rather easy to avoid. But yeah, they're clearly triggered by the alarms. I didn't actually realize they were ever in the game. capture on this.
Activating security scan.
I don't know, because I was actually thinking this game was actually this DLC add-on was pretty good. Up until we started backtracking. Now I'm not sure anymore. I don't know, I'll see how long we I'll see what we do next. If this is some endgame crap, then yeah, I don't even know. Not much to talk about during these loading screens.
Subject recognized.
Although it was very
access granted.
It was very stealthy what they did there. You know, with the whole, the scanning loading screens. I didn't actually think it was a loading screen the first time I went through it. So I gotta give them props for that. Not until the second or third time I went through it. Alright. Here it is.
Access granted.
Okay. I'm confused and afraid. Well, oh, I guess I can't use the ladders. Oh, neat.
Rapture.
Jensen, it's Keitner. Where are you?
In a well-concealed elevator inside the prison's restricted wing. Your gun-running neural engineer deserves a raise.
I take it the eye worked then. Good. Now listen, if what you say is true, if Burke really is using the prisoners here as lab rats, I need proof. Hard evidence that I can take to Interpol.
An entire prison full of kidnapped civilians isn't enough?
You're an ex-cop, Jensen. You tell me. How many death row inmates crying on about their innocence have you seen getting out?
Point taken. I'll see what I can find.
Another praxis point. What shall I... Oh, no, I can do Typhoon again. Sure, let's do that. Because I will, I fully intend on using that. It shouldn't be much longer now until I get a nice group of enemies. Oh, are you kidding? Why else would I be putting my weapon away unless it was like some sort of story event that was about to happen? Don't shoot the bad guy.
Not to die. Be free.
Oh, these people.
Please. Please don't leave me like this. No hope.
Oh, it's for that Hydra project thing, Bob.
Can't take anymore.
I don't think I... No. I definitely have level 6.
Be free.
It's level, sorry, level 5. Oh. Well, you know, whatever. She's, like, around. Debate ethics. Oh, another data storage device. And... Oh, it's probably a password I can get onto this computer. Yeah, here we go. S-G-S-U-L-P-K-T. That's a random password. Some kind of conversation history. And special request from Bell Tower.
So cold.
I guess they're talking about, I don't know. Oh, it's Burke. Okay. The character we heard nothing about. Oh, what the fuck. That's messed. I actually tased them during my pacifist run. Surprising. Okay, well. It's come to an end, Doc. Or wait, no, there's another ebook.
According to Commander Burke, initial field tests are positive. Operatives report function within expected parameters. Never mind the cost.
Quite the house of horrors you got here, Doc. You letting anyone in, or just women?
Who are you? How'd you get down here? This is a restricted area.
Obviously. You wouldn't want the rank and file knowing what kind of sick experimentation is going on down here.
No, you don't understand. I'm not...
Where's Burke? And your research partner, Savage.
Burke went back up to the base. And Gary left. Told me to be smart, keep my mouth shut, and do whatever Burke tells me to do. For now.
For now? I heard the three of you talking up there in the morgue. Sounded like you don't exactly fit in here, Dr.
Kavanaugh. And who the fuck are you?
The name's Jensen. I came here looking for someone. Megan Reed.
Reed? I've seen her research. Gary thinks it could be the key we're missing. If she can be convinced to come here.
Megan Reed was kidnapped, Kavanaugh. Violently. As was her entire scientific team and the dozens of women you've been torturing down here.
No! You don't understand. I'm trying to save them. Gary and I, we were sent here to put the OCM project back on track. It wasn't until we got here that we realized what that meant. And by then it was too late.
OCM. Savage used that term in the morgue. What does it mean?
Organic computational matrix. It's a means of cross-connecting living brain tissue and artificial intelligence systems to create a supercomputer of unparalleled capability. Part flesh, part silicon.
That's what you're doing down here, turning prisoners into computer parts.
Human brain activity has to be integrated with the technology, or else it won't work. Even DARPA knew that.
Just how many prisoners are being wired into this thing?
I don't know. But a lot of them don't seem to survive for more than a year. I've told the others there's no way this project can stay viable with these kinds of numbers. But the OCM computers have to have them to work.
Computers? You mean there's more than one of them?
There's several. This is just where the process starts, the factory floor. We select the candidates here, implant them, and ship them to the other locations. It's all very efficient.
Yeah, except your candidates keep dying. What does DARPA have to do with this?
Nothing. Not directly. In 2007, they started looking for research partners to help develop an artificial cognitive science program that could increase a soldier's situational awareness in the field. A number of private sector companies submitted proposals.
Bell Tower being one of them.
No. Bell Tower was a private military corporation. DARPA wanted researchers. But one of the companies who did submit something was a biotech corporation that deals with Bell Tower. And they believed a successful program could be designed if it could be wired directly into the soldiers' brains. DARPA wasn't willing to go that far.
So this biotech company took the idea to Bell Tower.
A corporation that, being privately funded, doesn't have to concern itself with political or ethical debate.
You seem to think Megan's research is integral to salvaging this project of yours. Why?
It's not my project. Had I known before I came here...
Right, just answer the question.
We're experiencing cross-systemic failures with the tech. Over time, subjects implanted with OCM augmentations suffer complete neurological breakdown. They pretty much burn up from the inside. Gary thinks it's a problem with the acceptance of the P-dot array.
I've heard that phrase before.
It's the building block of modern neuro-augmentations. Dr. Reed's been reshaping it, changing the way it bonds with living tissue. The mutagenic gene combination she's introduced into it, well, frankly, it's astonishing.
Enough to warrant her kidnapping? So she'd be forced to work on this project with you?
She's not on this project. I don't know what she's doing or where she is. This is the first time anyone's ever mentioned kidnapping.
You're really gonna stand there and try to justify your role in this, aren't you? People are being enslaved, Kavanaugh. Enslaved and crucified.
It wasn't like that at first. I thought we were gonna make a difference, do something incredible for the world.
Right. And look how incredible it turned out to be. But you can still make a difference, Doctor. You can help me blow the lid off this place.
Are you insane? I can't. There's too much money invested in this. Burke, the people I work for, they'll kill me. They'll hunt me down and kill me.
I know people who can protect you, hide you. Interpol is just waiting for evidence to tear Bell Tower apart.
It's not just Bell Tower. Oh, God. Oh, God, am I really gonna do this? You can't get me out through the prison. Burke would stop us.
Then we'll have to do what Savage did. Take a submersible.
We can't. The hatches to all the docking hangars are locked tight. The only way to unlock them is by using the security console in the prison command tower. Burke keeps an eye on us that way.
Then I'll have to go back up there and unlock it. Well, you gather as much evidence as you can carry.
Oh my God, I'm really gonna do this.
Damn right you are. Now get moving. I'll contact you when I unlock the hatch.
All right, fine. But Mr. Jensen, please, hurry.
Yeah, sure.